When you first start Excel, you're presented with several templates. Those are all of the squares on the right-hand side of the screen. A template is simply a partially completed normal workbook that contains the starting point for a task that you often need to do. You can put anything into a template that you can put into a regular workbook. You'll probably see different templates to the ones I'm seeing on my screen, as the templates constantly change. But you can see here there's a weight loss tracker, a retirement financial planner, and a monthly college budget. And if I scroll further down the screen, you can see many more templates. And if this isn't enough, you can also browse thousands of templates from Microsoft and other third parties by typing some keywords into the Search for Online Templates box at the top of the screen, provided, of course, you're connected to the internet. There are two types of template: sample templates and custom templates. Sample templates are templates that are similar to the ones you're seeing on screen now, templates that are created by Microsoft or another third party. And a custom template is a template that you create yourself. We're going to create a custom template in the next lesson. But let's open one of Microsoft's sample templates for the moment. I think I'll open the His and Her Weight Loss Tracker. So I click on the Weight Loss Tracker, and I can read a few words about what this sample template can be used for. I can see how other users have rated it. This one hasn't done very well with a 3-star rating. And then I can click the Create button to create a new workbook that's based on this template. So I'll click Create now, and the weight tracker appears on screen. It might seem at first as if sample templates are a replacement for having to learn Excel, but they're not quite as useful as they first promised to be. There's three potential problems in using them. First of all, sample templates often appear to provide a solution that's almost what you need, but you may find that the work involved in converting them to exactly what you need takes longer than starting from scratch. The second problem is that some templates include very convoluted and advanced Excel features that non-expert users will find difficult to understand. Just take a look at the formula in cell F19, and you may begin to understand what I mean by this. And the third problem is that some templates include VBA, that's Visual Basic for Applications code, to extend Excel's normal capability. While VBA code can be used to implement some very impressive features, it can be impossible to maintain or customize this type of workbook, unless you have access to a competent VBA programmer. For these reasons, I don't find a huge use for sample templates, but I find that custom templates are very useful. A custom template is a template that you've created yourself. Because you completely understand how custom templates work, you may find them far more useful than sample templates. And we'll be creating a custom template in the next lesson. In this lesson, we'll create a custom template folder. That's a place to store all of your custom templates in. By default, all templates for all Office applications, such as Excel, Word, and PowerPoint, are stored in the same folder. This isn't a great idea, as you may create a large number of templates, and they will be easier to work with if you organize them. A new feature for Office 2013 is the ability to set a different default custom template location for each Office application. It's useful to organize your templates properly, so we need a folder that will contain only Excel custom templates. If you work with Word and PowerPoint, you can use the same technique to create different folders for Word and PowerPoint custom templates. So let's now create our custom template folder. I'm going to open Windows Explorer and then navigate to my C drive. On your C drive, you'll find a folder called Users. And in this folder, you'll find a folder for each of the users of your computer. And in this folder, you'll find a folder named after your Windows login name. You can see that there are several potential users of my computer, but my login is msmart_2, so I'll click My Folder. Inside this folder, you'll find a Documents folder. I'll double-click My Documents folder now. And inside the Documents folder, you'll find a Custom Office Templates folder. So I'll double-click Custom Office Templates. And this is the folder where all Office templates are stored by default. But I'm going to create a special folder to keep my Excel custom templates in. So I'll right-click in the folder, select New from the shortcut menu, and then click Folder. And I'll name the folder Excel. I'll now close the Explorer window, and I'm back in Excel again. I now need to tell Excel where my custom template folder is. So I click File on the ribbon, then Options on the left-hand menu bar, and then Save on the left-hand menu bar. And notice that, by default, my default personal templates location is in that Custom Office Templates folder. So let's change the reference now so that it points at our new Excel folder. I click to the right of Custom Office Templates and type Excel. And I've now set the new location for my custom template folder. I'll now click OK, and I'm back in Excel. And now I'll close Excel. And I won't bother saving this workbook, so I'll click Don't Save. And you've now completed Lesson 314, Understand Templates and Set the Default Custom Template Folder.